as Lord Sri Rama. In 1972, training classes in summer were about to commence at Vrindavan. 800 devotees, boys and girls, selected from various regions of the country, assembled at Whitefield. Swami's mother, Ishwaramma, obtained his permission to join other women devotees at Vrindavan for the 30 days of training. She was given accommodation on the floor below that of Swami. The trainees woke up daily in the early hours. They went through the incantation of Omkar, Pranavam, devotional songs, yogasanas, bhajans, service to the poor and other activities. The participants were very enthusiastic and lively. For Ishwaramma, all that was like a festive occasion every day in the temple of Goddess Saraswati, the goddess of learning. On the 11th day of the training camp, Ishwaramma experienced a thrilling experience. The next morning, she rushed to Peddabottu, who was well known also as Shirini Ma. She was all excitement as she told Peddabottu, "I must inform you about a wonderful experience I had, but promise me that you never tell anybody about it." Peddabottu moved closer to her and confidentially inquired what it was all about. Said Ishwaramma, "Our Swami is truly God Himself. I have no doubt whatsoever." Peddabottu burst out laughing. Ishwaramma asked what was so funny about what she said. Peddabottu reassured her, No, I am not laughing at your words. I am only expressing my joy that this fact has come to your knowledge at long last. But leave that alone. Tell me how you have come to this realization." Ishwaramma said, "You know, I am having high fever for the last 4 days. Last night Swami came to me." Peddabottu interrupted, "Was it in a dream?" "No," said Ishwaramma. "I was not able to sleep and was uncomfortably rolling this side and that in bed. Swami came to me in person and inquired how I was feeling. I told him that my body was aching all over. Now, how should I tell you, Peddabottu? He is not our usual Swami whom you and I see every day. In a moment, he became Lord Sri Rama with a dazzling crown on his head and a long bow in his hand. He stood by my side. I was surprised but saluted him. I also tried hard to get up and sit on the bed, even to get out of it, but could not do so. In a few moments, Lord Sri Rama became our familiar Swami. He smiled gently and gave me a little Vibhuti Prasadam. He said, 'Fever will disappear, don't worry,' and left." Peddabottu was happy and elated. She said, "Swami has certainly blessed you. What a memorable experience." Ishwaramma was in full wakefulness and consciousness when she saw Sri Satyasai as Lord Sri Rama. She is indeed exceptionally fortunate and blessed. As subsequent events indicate, that divine experience she had was probably a pointer to the approaching merger of Ishwaramma's soul with the Supreme Being. The very next day, 6th May 1972, at 6 a.m., the trainees had just returned after completing Nagara Sankirtan. Swami gave them darshan from the balcony of his residence and went in to have a bath. Meanwhile, Ishwaramma had her bath, took her morning cup of coffee and sat down in the inner veranda to relax. Suddenly, she turned towards the bathroom and cried out for Swami. "Swami! Swami!" she called and collapsed. Swami responded from inside the bathroom, "I am coming, coming." That was all. She breathed her last. On 6th May 1983, Swami spoke on the occasion of the death anniversary of Ishwaramma. Referring to the special characteristics which distinguished the great lady and the manner of her death, he said, "Usually at such moments, one's mind dwells on ornaments of gold or similar valuables. It is only to very few persons that Swami comes to mind at the final moment. From the floor down below, she cried out for me, 'Swami, Swami.' I responded, 'I am coming, coming.' And she left. The situation is just like Mahavishnu rushing to bless Gajendra in response to his desperate call for divine succor. As the two live wires meet like a flash, in the moment, one attains salvation. At the crucial moment, Ishwaramma's daughter and granddaughter Venkamma and Sailaja were by her side. But she desperately cried out only for Swami. This is an ample proof of her piety and righteousness, the priceless reward for her great sadhana, practice of spiritual austerities. Here is an excellent example for emulation. As Sri Shyam Sundar, Swami Karunyananda spent several years with Ramana Maharishi in Arunachalam. For some years, he was also with Malayala Swami in Gogarbham near Tirupati. In 1927, he was ordained into sannyas, renunciation, by Shivananda Swami in Hrishikesh. He practiced many spiritual austerities. Later, he established the Gautami Jiva Karunya Sangam in Rajahmundry on the banks of the river Godavari in Andhra Pradesh and did great service to the poor and the needy. As a result of his spiritual attainments and his services to humanity, he was rewarded with the good fortune of remaining in close proximity to Sri Satya Sai. Once Sri Satya Sai Baba asked Karunyananda to come and sleep in his room. But being in the unfortunate habit of snoring, he hesitated to accept Baba's invitation. Swami told him not to worry about it, but to come and sleep in his room. Karunyananda has since stated, "Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai never sleeps. He lies in bed on his left side. His eyes are always half open. He is fully aware of what is happening all around him." Bhagavan vouchsafed Karunyananda an unforgettable experience that night. Swami was lying on his bed. Karunyananda spread his bed on the floor and slept. After some time, he woke up and sat and looked towards Swami's bed. Surprisingly, in place of Swami, he found Balakrishna, Krishna the child, lying in Swami's bed, emanating a charming bluish glow. Karunyananda lapped up the wonderful vision in astonishment. Unbelieving, he rubbed his eyes and looked again carefully. He also assured himself that he was wide awake and fully in possession of his senses. There was no question of any doubt. It certainly was Balakrishna lying on Baba's bed. After a few moments, once again Baba was seen lying there in place of Balakrishna. Karunyananda stated later, "What I witnessed was certainly not imagination. I was fully awake. It was Balakrishna most certainly. I also witnessed Balakrishna changing into Sri Satyasai." Bhagavan Satyasai does not publicly display his divinity. Perhaps he feels that such displays might lead to unmanageable crowds converging on him from far and wide. In Sai Shruti, Swami's residence in Kodaikanal, Swami spoke to his students once and revealed a divine secret. He said, "Lord Sriman Narayana has come down to this earth in human form as Satyasai. Please understand and accept this fact. Like Lord Sri Rama and Lord Sri Krishna, this too is a Purnavatar. Great sages and spiritual preceptors were sent here from time to time by the Divya Shakti. But here you see the very incarnation of the universal absolute on earth. As Gautama Buddha. Once a conference of scientists took place in Hyderabad in Andhra Pradesh under the chairmanship of Dr. Balakrishna. Professor Haikawa, a Japanese scientist, was among them. Dr. Balakrishna invited him to his home. There, Dr. Haikawa saw for the first time a colored photograph of Bhagavan Sri Satyasai Baba. He felt immediately drawn to it. In the temple-like house, this attractive photograph stood out in all its decorations. He thought that the picture might be of an honored ancestor of the family. During their conversation, Dr. Balakrishna described the divinity of Bhagavan Sri Satyasai Baba and told him that Baba was God incarnate. It so happened that Swami was right there in Hyderabad at that time, and the two scientists went to have his darshan. Swami kindly invited both of them into the interview room. In the proximity of Swami, Professor Haikawa experienced an intense awareness that he was in the presence of a divine personality. Swami gently smiled at him, waved his hand, produced a human heart and showed it to him. He was bewildered. Bhagavan asked him what it was. Dr. Haikawa replied that it was a human heart. "Do you know to whom did it belong?" asked Swami. He answered, "How do I know?" Bhagavan told him, "This is your own heart at the time of your birth." Dr. Haikawa was stunned. Swami explained, "This is indeed your own heart. Do not be surprised. As soon as you were born, your heart stopped beating. You were as good as dead. Your body turned blue. Your father was a man of faith and a very devout person. He placed your body at my feet and prayed to me. Oh God, I earnestly pray to you for a child. Is this the way you respond to my prayers? Of what use is this dead body to me? I therefore mended your heart and restored you to life." As a matter of fact, the age of the Japanese scientist was more than Baba's, and it was to Lord Buddha that his father had prayed, seeking revival of life in his dead son's body. The secret of that incident was known to no one except his parents. Dr. Haikawa realized that Lord Buddha, who had lived many centuries ago had now reincarnated in the form of Sai Bhagavan. During the conversation, Swami referred in a lighter vein to Dr. Haikawa as Avakaya, which in Telugu means mango pickle. As Jesus Christ, a Roman Catholic couple from America happened to hear about Bhagavan and came down to Puttaparthi. During public audience in Prashanti Nilayam, they saw the glorious form of Sri Satya Sai. They felt powerful spiritual waves being radiated to them. They were surprised and delighted as they experienced an intense glow of happiness. The man was overwhelmed by Baba's eyes, full of kindness and heart replete with love. He was convinced that Jesus himself had come to earth in Sai's form and told his wife as much. The woman did not, however, react favorably. "What nonsense," she said. "We are Roman Catholics. It is not proper for you to say that this Hindu is Jesus himself. I do not agree with you at all on this." She remained somewhat aloof from Sri Satya Sai. One day, Swami invited the couple into the interview room. The man was undoubtedly in great exhilaration. His wife was somewhat cold and sat a little aside. As the interview drew to a close, the man asked Swami politely, "Swami, may I take a photograph?" Swami agreed, and the gentleman took a few snaps with his camera. The film was developed and printed on their return home. What they saw was not Satya Sai, but the loving and compassionate figure of Jesus Christ. They were astonished. The woman felt extremely sorry that she could not recognize Jesus Christ when physically present in front of her in the form of Sri Satya Sai. Needless to say, she became Swami's devotee from that moment. A devotee asked Swami, "Jesus promised to come back again. Are you that Jesus?" Swami explained to him, "Jesus did not say that he would come back. What he actually said was that God, who had sent him to earth himself, would come." He pointed to a sheep. The cry of a sheep sounds, "Ba, ba." Jesus indicated that God would come to earth with that name. But his followers did not correctly comprehend what he had stated. "It is I who sent Jesus to the earth." The Kaaba in Baba's palm. When Professor S. Bashiruddin, a Muslim, visited Sri Sai Baba, Bhagavan materialized and presented to him a locket on which was inscribed Allah in Arabic. Allah in Arabic, Sarva Antaryami in Sanskrit, and Omnipresent in English, they all mean the same. Once some Arabic visitors met Sri Sai Baba in Prashanti Nilayam. It was the sacred day of Bakrid. Swami invited them into the interview room. He raised his open palm. The visitors saw in it a vision of thousands of devout Muslims praying on their knees before the Holy Kaaba in Saudi Arabia at that very moment. These are some of the instances to establish that Sri Satya Sai is not only the embodiment of all the gods. He is the transcendental encapsulation of every god. Many persons belonging to the Jewish faith testify to this fact, like Dr. Samuel Sandweiss, who declared, "I am convinced that Baba is the incarnation of God. Whatever descriptions about God are given in the Hindu, Christian, and Jewish lore and literature are not fictional or imaginary. they are all true. They all proclaim the truth that God has the supreme power to incarnate Himself as and when needed.